Note card number one. Two. Three. All right. Back up. My name is Joseph Simone. This is my speech number two for Communications 101. What is the Eucharist? What is its origin? What does it do? The Eucharist, we as Catholics believe, is the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Christ. The Eucharist was his gift to us, and it was the command that he gave us at the Last Supper. Christ also is the physician of souls, and the Eucharist is a medicine which is given to us to heal our body and our soul, spiritually and physically. Why do we believe that the Eucharist is the body and blood of Christ? We know that in all four gospel accounts, at the Last Supper, Christ said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. It is my body, which has been given up for you." He says something similar for the blood. Also, in the testimony of John, we know that he has said, "Unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man, you shall not have life within you." The Gospels make it abundantly clear that the Eucharist is important and literal. One of the practical aspects of the Eucharist, in addition to being in complete communion with God and increasing and being one of the rules of the Catholic Church, is that when you receive it, your venial sins are forgiven completely through the process of the Mass, such as the Confiteor and the reception of the Eucharist, which is God. Your venial sins are wiped away. This has multiple effects. One, your time in purgatory would be lessened as something of an indulgence, and temporal punishment for venial sins is removed. Now that confuses some people. Temporal punishment for sin is half of the punishment for sin. In the New Testament and Old Testament, it is established that the price of sin is twofold, in the world and afterwards. Such as, for example, when King David had committed adultery, the Lord had forgiven him and had spared him from hell, though had killed the child, which was born of this adultery. King David had to suffer here, but was forgiven there. By wiping away venial sin, misfortune, and other ways of paying for it in this world are made clear. I'm sure that some of you have noticed times where you've done something wrong and then, seemingly karmically, something bad happens to you. Indulgences and reception of the Eucharist do lessen these effects and sometimes prevent them. Furthermore, there have been numerous substantiated claims of miraculous Eucharistic healing. These claims do not require, teaching the dogma of the Catholic Church does not require that these miracles happened, but they have. And they serve only as further proof that God heals all, not only in spirit, but in body. In conclusion, the Eucharist is the most blessed sacrament. It was given to us by Christ, who is God, and it is the most important thing that a Catholic can participate in. Every morning, Monday, every morning of the weekdays, this church holy family has an hour after Mass where the Eucharist is exposed and people can pray in his presence. And and an hour of adoration of the Most Blessed Sacrament has helped me and has helped other people in this church. The Eucharist, the Most Blessed Sacrament, is the most important feature of the Catholic Church. And flip cards again. 3, 2, and 1. Please pan the audience, and then hit stop.